Welcome to Your Florida Lawn, the environmentally friendly way to grow and sustain a Florida-friendly landscape. Your host is Dr. Lori Trenholm, residential turf grass specialist with the University of Florida's Institute of Food and Agricultural Sciences. Join Lori and her special guests as they offer tips and solutions to maintaining a Florida-friendly lawn.
Well, this sod looks really good. I don't see any weeds in it. It's green and it looks like it's ready to be planted. Today we're going to be talking to you about some tips for planting sod, whether you have to plant an entire lawn or whether you're just repairing a few areas in the lawn. If you follow these steps, it will help you to ensure that your sod gets off to a great start.
Inspect your sod to make sure that it is weed-free and looks green and healthy. Do not leave sod sitting on the pallet for longer than overnight. Sod left on the pallet declines quickly and has greater susceptibility to disease, and this could lead to problems with establishment.
When you plant your sod, what you want to do is try and put it in a brick-like pattern so that the seams are not all running together. So, for example, we've got a seam here, and then our next seam in this next row will be over here. That's going to help the sod to grow together and establish more quickly, and it will eliminate the lines that you'll see. They will disappear more quickly, and the sod will grow in more tightly. It's also very important when you're planting sod that you get it as tight together as you possibly can. So after you put a piece down, give it a kick, make sure that it's tight to the rows next to it, and sometimes you'll wind up with little bare patches like you can see we've got here. So what you do is you'll always have a few pieces of sod that don't hold together quite as well. You can take those pieces and create little plugs out of them, and you just put those plugs in and fill in those bare areas, and they'll just grow right down in there, and that will look like it was never more than one piece of sod there. Another area over here, just do the same thing. Always remember green side up, and that will all just fill in. You want to make sure that you don't leave gaps or spots, because that is going to just be an opportunity for weeds to come in and invade. So your objective here in planting this sod is to get it as tightly together as possible, have your ground prepared well ahead of time, and then we're going to talk about how you should irrigate your new sod in.
It is important that your new sod be irrigated correctly to encourage fast establishment and root growth. For the first 7 to 10 days, irrigate 2 to 3 times a day for about 10 minutes each time. This keeps the sod from drying out while the roots are starting to grow down into the soil. For the next 7 to 10 days, irrigate once a day at about 1/4 of an inch. For the next 7 to 10 days, irrigate every other day at just about 1/2 inch. At this time, the roots should be established and the grass will be ready for a maintenance irrigation regime that follows our existing irrigation recommendations. Do not fertilize your new lawn for at least 30 and up to 60 days after planting. There are barely any roots on sod when it is harvested, so the grass does not have the ability to take the fertilizer up, which may lead to fertilizer leaching through the soil, and this can contribute to non-point source pollution of groundwater. The turf should not be in need of nutrients before this 60-day period, as it is generally fertilized prior to harvest at the sod farm.
So here you can see the lawn we've created from laying this sod. And you can see we've got a nice lawn that's going to grow together and be a healthy, happy Florida lawn. For the University of Florida IFAS Extension Service and Florida Friendly Landscaping, I'm Dr. Lori Trenholm for Your Florida Lawn.
Thank you for joining us for this segment of Your Florida Lawn. For more information on how to maintain your Florida friendly landscape, please visit our website or contact your local University of Florida County Extension office.